The 28th FISU Universiade enters its second week of action. The whole city is focused on the event. The ice hockey Halleck Arena Stadium is full every day. Without a doubt, ice hockey is one of the most popular sports in Kazakhstan. After a long absence, Sweden is present for the third consecutive time now at the Winter Universiade. Since they come back, they've got progressively better. In Almaty, 21 players from all over Sweden. Team captain Erik Lyrvall's team is made up of the best athletes from all across Swedish universities.
Well, we played Czech yesterday. We started pretty good. I think we had a first period where we were quite even. We battled hard. It was 1-0 to Czech after that period. Then, unfortunately, we had a couple of injuries. We had one guy who got hit in his face and had to get stitches, and I hurt my leg, unfortunately. So we were down a few guys, and Czech played really hard, and they came out well in the second period, and they scored 4 goals in the second period. So, unfortunately, I think the game was lost there in the second period. And then third period, we finished okay, playing 0-0, but all in all, they won 5-0. But Czech is a good team. They played well, so... But we can do better.
We first met Erik a few weeks ago in Stockholm. He was born in Falun and is studying at the Stockholm School of Economics, where he's a student in finance studying in his first year of a 2-year master's. He's the captain of the Swedish team. He's worked hard to prepare for the Universiade and is committed to finding ways of achieving the dream shared by the 21 guys on his team, all of them passionate about playing ice hockey.
He's a really, really good guy. He's really good in school. I know he has some good grades there and is very promising in school. Now I think he plays hockey most for fun, but when we are on the ice he is really tough, and he's big guy and very strong and tough. So he's a leader in this group.
One of the youngest teams at the tournament, the young Swedes have an impressive academic background.
We have a master in finance, bachelor in marketing. We have a master in civil engineering and business, 2 degrees. We have a civil engineer, we have a construction engineer, civil engineer, mechanical engineer and business, 2 degrees. We have a civil engineer, we have another civil engineer, we have a civil engineer, we have a chemical engineering, law student, we have a bachelor in finance. We're here, we have a physical therapist, vehicle engineering, very smart guy. We have a teacher, but he's in the shower, math teacher, high school math.
Group A was a tough group. Kazakhstan benefited from hometown advantage. As expected, the passionate crowd were a huge ally for the national team.
If we play Kazakhstan, it's going to be, first of all, it will be really fun to play here against the home nation, you know, and they'll have a lot of fans. I mean, I think the Kazakhstan team is really good. They have a couple of guys who played in the KHL this year. But we got to play defensively and just do our best, and I think we have a chance, but it's going to be tough.
The Kazakh team dominated the game, were consistently on the offense. However, if it hadn't been for the Swedish goalkeeper, the score would have been much, much higher. The Kazakh team won 5-0. They now have 6 points and are firmly at the top of Group A. Results of this match had a negative impact on Sweden's morale. Erik, as captain, needed to motivate the guys, and they listened to him intently.
He's a good leader, talked to the press a lot, and he's showing us in the team what to do, and he's a great responsibility.
The players themselves paid for the plane ticket to come to Almaty. Erik was totally in charge of the logistic details. The university had was a huge project for all of them.
A bit different for us than for many other nations, because a lot of countries as ice hockey federations put a lot of resources into getting a great team together and providing them with a staff of maybe 5 to 10 people with video coaches and equipment managers, etc. But we don't get anything like that, so it's all on us students and the Swedish Student Athletic Association to administer this. So it's been a lot of work, you know, finding players, getting the coach, and then getting our jerseys and just flying here. But it's all worked out well, and now we're here, and it's fantastic to be here in Almaty to compete.
These Swedish players knew before the game with China they would have to score at least 11 goals and could not concede any. Well, in this case, they would finish ahead of the US team and would get into the quarterfinals. It was a hard slog and a few down faces, but they were out for the battle once again, and they weren't going to hold back this time.
Situation going in, knowing you have to score 11 goals, but we came off to a hot start, scoring several goals in the first minutes, and just kept going from there. So you know, I think it's important to get some goals early and get confidence that we can score. So and then we just kept going, we never let go, and it was a really good team effort.
As a result, the Swedish team made their plan and it worked. The Swedes beat China 15-0 and made it through to the final eight in the competition. Quarterfinal opponents, Kazakhstan, for the second time, and this time it was sudden death.
I think we have a pretty good start, play really hard. 1-0 after first, but we're really in it, keep working, and then we go out in the second place, 0-0, we have some chances, we just don't score, but we're still in it, and we fight really hard, and we go out in third, and I think we have a lot of energy, we fight till the end, and we really tried, we did our best, but it wasn't enough this time either, but yeah, we're going to keep fighting, now we have two more games.
Kazakhstan beat Sweden 4-0 in a more tightly fought affair. The Kazakhstan is through to the semi-finals at the Universiade. In the end, Sweden lost again to Japan and finished in seventh place. But we take our hats off to the Swedes. They most certainly do deserve it. Well done, guys.